Do you love your mom? Do you think she wasted her life, didn't live up to her fullest potential because she cared for you? Well, that's what Katy Perry thinks. Hey, if you guys like this video, please like, share, subscribe, send it out to other people if you get a giggle. If you find something profound, if it changes the way you think about things, share it with everybody else. It helps us get our message out there, which we hope impacts the world for the kingdom. Today we are talking about Sarah Beth Leib. I think I'm pronouncing that name correct. She is a contestant on American Idol. And I will be honest, I'm not a big fan of the show. Not super familiar with it. I mean, obviously it's been on for decades or whatnot. So I am familiar with it, but not an avid viewer. I've seen a couple of auditions, mostly YouTube videos. And that's how this came up. Kind of came up as a suggested YouTube video. Watched an audition, and then most recently, her walking off stage and saying, you know, I'm done, I'm going back home to my kids.
This opportunity is really rad, but this is actually gonna be my last performance because my heart's at home, so I'm gonna get home to my babies. They kind of need me, so thank you, thanks.
What just happened? She's gonna leave, what's happening?
You know, there's a lot of drama around this, and I think there's a lot of publicity around it too, like kind of planned PR that goes along with any kind of show of this caliber that is having this kind of reach. Obviously, there's storylines that they're bringing in. You know, Sarah Beth, in one of her responses on TikTok, I believe, addressed that she was actually recruited to audition for this show.
My name is Sarah Beth, and I'm 25, and I'm from California.
You cannot be 25. What are you saying?
Yes, 25.
No,
16. 16.
I mean, come on.
Bless, you guys are my favorite.
Give us a real,
I have three kids, so that's like.
Get away from here. What are you saying?
You okay, Katie?
Nope.
It's okay.
If Katie lays on the table, I think I'm gonna pass out.
Three kids.
Honey, you've been laying on the table too much.
No.
You know.
So how did you get from mom to music?
Dude, I'm not gonna lie. I'm not really a musician. I just called Lionel Richie, dude.
No,
sir,
no, it's all right.
Sir,
no,
I'm not gonna.
No, it's okay.
Oh my gosh. Anyway, I like to go to karaoke, like with my friends, and I did like a little bit of like church choir, and
is
then
this
now,
your dream?
We.
Is it now? If it's not your dream, you might need to leave because there's a lot of dreams behind you.
Right. Literally, I'm still processing. I can't even like answer. Like this is so much.
Let's hear
all
this.
All right, well, let's, why don't you freak us out, Freaky Friday?
The cherry bomb.
What are you gonna sing for us?
I was supposed to sing Benny and the Jets, but then my voice is, so now I'm gonna sing You Know I'm No Good by Amy Winehouse, and I hope it goes okay.
Okay, give it to us.
Okay. Like I knew that I would.
Come on, we need more.
But I told ya, I was troubled. Oh, you know that I'm no good.
That's not enough.
I know.
Try Benny and the Jets.
Try it.
Try
what do you got to lose?
Nothing.
Okay.
It's not her dream yet.
All right, okay.
Show us what your voice can do. Take it to the limit. No looking back. Sing it like it's your new dream.
All right.
So when we look at her audition kind of come in and we see some of the drama that happened there, I mean, she's obviously got this very like fun personality. She's a little, got all this nervous energy. She's very unique. She's, you know, young and vibrant in energy, but also kind of nervous. And there's just a uniqueness to her personality. Which is seen by the idol judges. But there's this thing that happens where she talks about being 25, having three kids, and Katy Perry just like, you know, goes over dramatic with it, makes a comment that I think was probably inappropriate.
Honey, you've been laying on the table too much.
I take this as kind of a little bit of a sexual innuendo, like you're giving it up a little bit too often or something. It's at least how I took it. You know, not the end of the world and the drama that's coming out of it. We don't need to make a big deal of that. But it does kind of reveal, in my mind, the way that Katy Perry sees priorities in life. And I don't think that Katy's perspective on this is very different from modern feminism, the cultural elites, the woke left. I mean, any of these labels that we put on kind of philosophical movements within our culture. There seems to be a devaluing of motherhood. And I see that in the audition, but I also saw it in the clips or the articles that I've seen and read through on when Sarah Beth left. And she said, you know, like, I miss my kids. I'm going to go home. You know, she told a producer backstage, I know I'm not going to win the show anyway, so I might as well go home. Katy Perry's response to her.
Sarah Beth, I know. Life is scary.
For sure.
I also know that it's easier to walk away than to be rejected. But then I also know that you lose out on your fullest potential. And I know that you love your family for your kids. I know that as a mother. But remember, self-love is just as big as motherly love. Don't leave the competition.
It's interesting that Katy's the one that's like pleading to her not to leave. She was also the one telling her that this isn't your dream, and I have this respect for all of these people out there, and you're not, you know, in essence, worthy of this. You need to kind of like get it together and cut ties with some of these things that are weighing you down. But I think particularly there's this concept of fullest potential. And if we look at our society, don't even look at men versus women, just if someone reaches their fullest potential in our society, what does that mean? What is the fullest potential that you can reach? And our society would most likely attach that to some sort of income level, some sort of freedom that we have to do the things that we want to do, some sort of influence that we would have over other people. These things would be the fullest potential, the realizing of your fullest potential, to make the most money, to have the most power, to have the most influence, to have the most freedom and ability to be the master of your own life. So in essence, the more detached you are from other people, the more fulfilled you are. And this is a lie of the enemy. We're not created to have this as our purpose. In fact, this is a corruption of desire. You know, just as like it says in James, right? You know, like we have these desires within us and they get hooked and then they pull us into sin and that sin develops into death. And if we follow that kind of line of reasoning, like reaching your fullest potential by, you know, giving up time with your kids, giving up time with your family, and pursuing this dream of music, a music career, that somehow is you living to your fullest potential. That's not. That's just a career choice. I mean, military people do this, right? They make a career choice to go and serve in the military, and that requires them to pull away from their family. You know, I used to travel for work. You know, I would go to churches and do training and consultation. That would pull me away from my family for periods of time, and then I would go to work. And I'm making a decision to do that in that particular time because the pay was well, we could manage the schedule, we have technology that can kind of help keep me connected, but it's a career choice. It's not me living to my fullest potential. And this is something, especially in entertainment, you know, like we're in the entertainment field in the sense of communication and media. As creator films, you know, we want to create content that people are entertained by, engaged by. We hope that, like the parables of Christ, that it has an influence in it as well, that lifts up the good, the righteous, the true. But we know that we're in an industry that says that this has to be it all. We've even had some of our coworkers and interns here at the company have talked about hearing Christian producers stand up in front of their school and say that if this is what you want to do, like you're not going to get married, you're not going to have these things, it has to be everything, it's got to be your, you know, you have to sacrifice everything to pursue this. These are well-known Christian producers. And I would say no. If you have to sacrifice everything to pursue your career, what if God is in it? Like what's there? You need to make strategic decisions in life. And motherhood is not just a sacrifice that we go for. This motherhood is not something that is simply, you know, a responsibility that we're stuck with. It's a beautiful thing that God uses to teach us. You know, and motherhood and fatherhood are different, but being parents have some crossover. So I speak to this as a father, and I can tell you that as a father, I've learned so many things about God through the raising of my kids. And for someone to tell me that that is a burden that's holding me back from reaching my fullest potential is absurd. But as a father, part of my command from God is to provide, is to protect, is to go out. And I've been built genetically to do some of that. And a mother doesn't have that same DNA, doesn't have that same general genetic disposition to go and be the, you know, foreign advisor and the battle and the protection and stuff. I mean, my wife is a warrior and she can protect just like anybody else. But even in that, there's a responsibility as a father that's different than a mother. But the truth still stands in that to say that either of these things is something that holds you back from reaching your fullest potential is something that our culture tells you and is a deception of the enemy to devalue something that is good. If you look at anybody who has reached the pinnacle of life, and by pinnacle, I don't mean wealth and prosperity. I'm talking about age. People who have come to the end, they've aged well, they've gone through things. They will tell you the thing that they most cherished was time with their family. The thing that gave them the most fulfillment was their children. And when you see stories like this and you see lines of reasoning like this being fed primarily through American Idol to, you know, younger generations, you wonder, what is our society going to look like if we don't, as Christians, stand up against these ideologies, these thoughts, these philosophies, and say, no, this is wrong, and take firm stances. So that's what we do here, and you can join us. Like, share, subscribe this. You know, we are going to be launching another crowdfunding campaign, so if you are interested in investing in creator films, you can always do that. Follow our channel for more details as that comes out in the next couple of weeks. We believe it is our responsibility as filmmakers, as media producers, to be a light into the world, and we can only do that through the help of people like you. So join us, follow us, join the newsletter, all that kind of stuff, and we will have more about that coming soon. But we hope that you enjoyed this video, and tune in for our next one. We're thankful for the following that you guys have for us and the encouragement that you have in trying to create a voice for Christ in this space.